Good evening, respected ones. In this video, I have come with a language theory called Basil Bernard Burstein's Sociolinguistic Theory of Language Codes. Basil Bernard Burstein is a British sociologist and linguistic scholar. According to Burstein, there is a strong relationship between the social division and language. That is, there is a strong relationship between social class and language. If you are asked to define the theory, you can just write the theory. Sociolinguistic theory of language codes is a theory put forth by Basil Bernard Burstein, which tells that there is a strong relationship between social class and language. Different social classes speak some words and sentences in the particular dialect spoken by them as some codes. These codes may not be understood by others at times. Sometimes such codes may be understood by people out of the particular group as well. It is on the basis of the nature of the words and phrases used by the particular group of people. For example, all of us are speaking Malayalam, but we may not be able to follow or understand the dialect spoken by some people in Kerala. At the same time, we may be able to understand the language codes used by some other groups. For example, in my native place, we are using eating. Actually, the real usage in mother tongue is evitable. But if I use eating, then the other Malayalis also may be able to recognize what I wanted to convey, because there is a similarity between these two words. So this is because this is a elaborated code. According to Burstein, the language codes can be divided into two: a restricted code and elaborated code. As I told earlier, the words and phrases used by some particular group cannot be understood by some other groups who belong to the same mother tongue. For example, we will not be able to understand the dialects used by some people who are residing at coastal areas. Such codes are, or such language users are known as restricted codes. Then the words and usages used by some other communities as a part of their dialect, or some other people, some other groups of people as a part of their dialect, can be realized by or understood by the people who are out of the group but belong to the similar mother tongue, though they feel some difficulty. Yeah. And this restricted code and elaborated code can be seen in our educational system also. For example, if you look at mathematics, it has got some technical terms which may not be understood by people who are not doing a mathematics course. But if in the case of English, the words used in English course or English subject can be understood by students of other departments too. So you can tell that English department uses elaborated code, but mathematics department uses restricted code. But according to Bernstein, there is a concept of classification and framing. If you are classifying different subjects, if you are classifying different subjects in a strong manner, then you can see that all the departments as exclusive frames. There will not be any sort of relationship between English department and mathematics department or among different departments. Then the language used in different departments may become a restricted course. But if you try to connect these departments by using a language teaching strategy like LAC, then you can make the language course elaborated. So this interconnection or this collaboration will help you to make different language course more elaborated. So this is something about this theory and framing. Again, we can go back to framing. The framing means the arrangement of classroom activities. You can arrange the classroom activities in different manner. And if you are deciding that the teacher only will decide how should be the expressions and who should be expressing the items inside the classroom, or you can make freedom, or you can give freedom to your students to express, to decide in which language or in which dialect they should express. So if it is a student friendly or learner centered framework or framing, then teacher will allow students from different cultural backgrounds to make use of their own codes of language. If the teacher does so, then each and every student will be able to speak in a fluent manner. The matter is that teacher should learn the language course of each student who comes from different cultural background. So this Bernstein also was against the deficit theory of language. According to Bernstein, if you allow the students to make use of their own language course to speak about some topics, then they can perform well. And the teacher can help them to come out of their language core to the general language core, and teacher can help them to learn a foreign language in an effective manner. This is what is explained by Basil Bernstein through his sociolinguistic theory of language course.